I know that you can stand. For your life is in His hand.
Through the valley of the shadows of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they fall comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Lord, God, have been out of other places from all generations. And say, return ye children of man. For 1,000 years in thy sight is but as yesterday. And it has passed as a watch in the night. Thou carries them away as with the flood. They are as asleep. In the morning they are like grass that grows up. In the morning it flourishes. In the evening it is brought down. And it withers. We are consumed by thy anger. Sins in the light of thy conscience. For all our days are passed away in thy wrath. We spend our years as a tale, death's toll. The days of our years are 80 years and 10. And if thy reasonable strength they be forespoken. Yeah, the strength and the labor and the sorrow. But it's soon cut off. And we fly away.
Red.
Weeping may endure for a night, but joy will come in the morning. Nine hands of my mistress.
Pastor Thomas, to the pulpit, a Christian friend to the bereaved family. It's always hard for me when I see and witness the homecoming celebration of one of my celebration of life, February 1st, 1995, April 23rd, 2024, the beach of Rashawn State. Today, May 18th, 12th, noon, One Step Baptist Church, Pastor Tyrone Thomas, officiated. The interpret will be in Zion Hill Cemetery, Baltimore. All of you have programs, and the service will proceed as follows. Yours truly, Tommy Campbell, serving as mistress on board.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. From the rise of the sun to the going down of the same, His name is worthy to be praised. Yes, even in times like these, God's name is worthy to be praised. So I want to say to the May family today, be strong in the Lord. Trust Him, the Almighty, and everything will be all right. For our scripture reading, Old Testament, coming from Psalms 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me lie down in the green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for His name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for Thou art with me. Thy rod, Thy staff, and they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemy. Thou anoint my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. Amen.
And I will dwell
in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Amen. Our New Testament reading comes from Paul's letter to the church at Corinth. 2 Corinthians 5, 1 through 8. For we know that if our earthly house, this tent, is destroyed, we have a building from God, a house not made with the hands, eternal in the heavens. For in this we groan, earnestly designed to be clothed with our habitation, which is from heaven. If indeed, having been clothed, we shall not be found naked. For we who are in this tent groan, being burdened, not because we want to try to be unclothed, but for the clothed, that mortality may be swallowed up in life. Now he who has prepared us for the very thing is God, who also has given us the Spirit as a guarantee. So we are always confident, knowing that while we are at home in the body, we are absent from the Lord. For we walk by faith and not by sight. We are confident, yes, well pleased, rather to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Father, the maker and the creator of heaven and earth, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. Lord, it's again that we come now to lift up this bereaved family today, God. Lifting up this mother and this uncle and this entire family, God. We're praying now, God, that you would just strengthen them, Lord, that they will be able, God, to mourn with honor the homegoing of their loved one, God. Lord, when everybody's gone, Lord, we pray that your Spirit still abodes in them, God. Give them the strength and the courage, oh God, to take it day by day and night by night. Lord, we lift them up right now, God. We pray for them, God. Teach them, God, to love one another, to come together in strength, to find strength in each other, God, to love one another and to courage each other during these difficult times. And Lord, when it's all over and done and we won't be able to sing Zion hymns anymore, we ask you to receive our soul in your kingdom. In Jesus' name, we do pray. Amen.
I've learned how to live holy.
All right.
And oh, I've learned how to live right. I've learned look out for him. Everybody look out for him. It's a hard one.
It was my ride. I remember we used to sit in the bathroom. You know what I'm saying? Trap on the toilet. I'm in the shower. You know what I'm saying? He made a beat. And I'm rapping. And we'll flip it up. I might be on the toilet. He in the shower. You know what I'm saying? We make a beat. And I'm, you know what I'm saying? Vice versa. You know what I'm saying? Like, grandma always, you know what I'm saying? Grandma pushing all the time. Rocking the dishes. All that, you know what I'm saying? Like, I miss my brother, though, you know what I'm saying? But I ain't no purpose people. I ain't gonna hold y'all long. Oh, yeah, I want to talk about my grandma and my uncle back, too. I ain't sitting there on their last funeral. I love them, too. You know what I'm saying? Y'all gotta think about them, too, though. Y'all keep them in y'all prayer. That's all I can say about them, too.
I told y'all I was gonna come up here with you, bro. I love you, bro. I love trap. It don't matter how good a public speaker you can be, you never want to speak at occasions like that, man. So I just want to thank everybody in the room. And I just want to say this. My last conversation that I had with Trout, Trout asked me to start a petition, right? He asked me to start a petition. This was less than 3 weeks ago, y'all. He asked me to start a petition and have everybody decide. And let everybody know that he is not a bad person, but Trap was a good person. And hold on, Trap was my friend, my brother, man. I love you, bro. I love all my love, the family, to the Reed family. I just want everybody to know today and sign a petition in their heart and their mind and know. Today in this room, I want everybody in this room to sign a petition in their heart and mind and know Trap was a good person, man. And make Trap rest in peace and forever live in our heart. Forever live Trap.
Amen.
Hard to see tomorrow when someone you love is gone. It's harder still to realize that your life can still go on. The Lord won't give you burdens He knows you cannot bear. He will not leave you comfortless. You will always find Him there. We are all our Father's children on earth and up above. Your loved ones walking close to God, surrounded by His love. We, the family of the late Rashawn May, would like to express our sincere thanks and gratitude for the many acts of kindness and support extended to us during the passing of our dear loved one. Your expression of kindness and support through prayers, thoughts, and deeds are deeply appreciated and will always be remembered. May God continue to bless each of you, the family of the Jews. Charlotte, May, Hal Rachel, blessed to Aubrey Larkin's Lewis Brothers Grandma. Interment will be at Zion Hill Cemetery. Now we will have the eulogy of Reverend Tyrone Knox.
Oh.
Let us pray. Gracious and eternal God, Lord, we thank you again for this day. Thank you for your Son, Jesus, your Holy Spirit, Lord. Now, Lord, we ask that you would bless this Berean family in a special way. Help them to understand what they cannot change and give them wisdom to know the difference. And have all of us mindful that we too are experiencing traveling in a barren land. Where we're here today, we're gone today. But you said in my Father's house, there are many mansions. We ask now in the name of Jesus that you would bless the legacy of Brother Demetrius right now. And bless his family within a special way. Now, Lord, you are the Father. I am the clay. You must increase, and I must decrease. Come, Holy Spirit. We need thee now. Come, Holy Spirit. For we need thee now. It is in the Master's name of our Christ we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I want to say to this bereaved family, to all of us that are looking on this day, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding. To these pulpiteers of Calvary. And I'm so happy when I looked around and I said, all of them are Bellamy Knights. All of us come from the town of Bellamy. God is good. He's good all the time. I mean, you know God is good.
God is good.
And he's good all the time. And he's worthy to be praised.
Yes, sir.
I want to talk just for a few moments from John 14:3. Yeah. Jesus speaks to his disciples and he says, if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. That where I am, there ye may be also.
All right, John.
I want to talk about a walk with Jesus.
Anybody
in this house is walking with Jesus?
Yes, sir.
I don't know about you, but every day of my life,
go ahead, preacher.
I want to have a walk with Jesus.
Demetrius,
I've been knowing him for a long time. Matter of fact, he was a member of our youth department.
All right.
Not only that, he sung in our youth choir.
So
I want to say to you today, he had a walk with Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Regardless of where he was, he was still walking with Jesus. I used to see him on occasionally walk by my house as a little boy day by day. And so when his uncle called me, I said, yes, y'all can have it here. Y'all welcome here at Morningstar Baptist Church because Demetrius was here at Morningstar Baptist Church.
Go ahead.
And what I love about Jesus, he says, whom the Father have put in my hands, there's no way that they can be cast out. Can I get a witness? I know that all of us, we don't talk about Jesus every day, but every now and then in our life, we have to lift up his holy name because he's worthy to be praised. How many know that he's worthy to be praised? I don't think Brother Demetrius was a sad man. He was a happy man. Can I get a witness? So he was happy. I think we need to rejoice at his coming because on the other day he had a walk with Jesus. Can I get a witness? And so when we look at this Berean people, when we look at John's writing in this text this morning, and we have to understand when John writes this gospel, he writes it some 80 years after the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Can I get a witness? Jesus states these words that I am the resurrection and I am the life. And not only does he state that, but he lets us know, though he was dead, yet shall he live again. Because what we see merely here is just, we see here the clay that is laying right here. But Demetrius, I believe right now that he's with the Lord. Can I get a witness?
So
when John writes this pericope about Jesus, you got to understand he was one of the closest disciples to Jesus. And when he writes this pericope about Jesus, John is ecstatic about the life of Jesus Christ. And I want to encourage every one of you today to get excited about Jesus Christ. Because I want to tell you, all of us in here this morning, I don't care who you are, we need him in our life. Can I get a witness? And that's why I wanted to tell you when I started out, I knew Demetrius as a young little boy.
Yeah.
And I knew him when he became a grown man.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness?
Go ahead.
And he always had high respect for me because I was always Reverend Thomas to Demetrius.
All right.
Can I get a witness?
Go ahead.
God writes this gospel, you got to understand in chapter 11, Jesus shows up at the graveside of Lazarus and he says, Lazarus, come forth.
Yeah.
But now three chapters over in chapter 14, he's talking to his disciples. Can I get a witness?
Yes,
and as he talked to his disciples, they are grieving for Jesus because they realize as long as Jesus is with them, they don't have to worry about nothing.
Yeah.
Ain't you glad that Jesus is omnipotent today?
Yes, sir.
Ain't you glad that he's everywhere, all
yes,
at the same time?
Yes,
he's at my house. He's at your house. He's everywhere, all at the same time. He's an omnipotent God. Can I get a witness?
Oh, yes,
that's why I don't care where you go. I think David said, if I made my bed in hell, thou art there. If I ascended to the heavens, thou art there. David lets us know that wherever we are, can I get a witness?
Go ahead. Go ahead,
that he's with us today.
Oh, yes, sir.
Now, when he writes this gospel, those disciples, like I told you, they was kind of grieving at this particular time. Jesus had not gone, but Jesus was preparing his disciples. All of us, I don't care who you are today, we got to get prepared to meet Jesus. Can I get a witness? I said, we got to get prepared to meet Jesus.
Yeah.
Jesus says to his disciples as he called them in, let not your heart be troubled.
All right. All right.
You believe in God. Believe also in me.
Yeah.
And I want to tell you, family, this afternoon, I know you're going to cry, but I still believe that Demetrius believed it in God.
Oh, yeah.
Anybody out there believe in God?
Oh, yes, sir.
And know that God is a very present help.
Oh, yes, sir.
In a time of trouble.
Yeah.
And so I believe that he believed in God. So Jesus tells his disciple, he encouraged his disciple, let not your heart be troubled.
Yeah.
If you believe in God, believe also in me.
Yeah.
I want to say to this mom, this uncle, I want to say to this family this afternoon, just trust God this afternoon.
Yes, sir.
God knows what he's doing better than you and I knows it. Can I get a witness this afternoon?
Father's house. Yeah.
There are many mansions. I was thinking as I was getting ready to do this eulogy, what would I say in this eulogy? But there's an old hymn in the church that says these words, when I can read, y'all are helping my title clear, to mansions in the sky. I don't care what you thought about it, what you think about others, but when I can read, my title clear. To mentions in the sky, I'll bid farewell to every fear and wipe my weeping eye. And that's what I want to tell you, encourage your family. The other day, Demetrius just read his title clear.
Go ahead, Doc.
And so John says, he says, in my Father's house,
go ahead, Doc.
There are many mentions.
Yeah.
And when he talks about the mentions, he said, there are many rooms.
Yeah.
Him and Darius don't have to argue about the bathroom anymore. Demetrius got his own place. Can I get a witness? And I want to tell you this afternoon, if you trust God, God got his own place for you this afternoon. I don't care who you are, what they may say about you, but trust in the Lord. Then John goes on to say, if it were not so, Jesus said, if it were not so, I wouldn't have told you. Thank you, Reverend Spencer, for reading Paul's letter. 2 Corinthians 5, for we know that if our earthly house or this tabernacle was dissolved, we got a building of God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. Yes, that's what Demetrius is on right now. He's around God's throne. That's what Jesus says in his pericope in verse number 3, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I'll come again and receive you unto myself. When you see that word receive, it means to welcome you. When you see that word receive, it means that everything gonna be all right. Thank David for saying that weeping may endure for a night, but joy will come in the moment. Anybody know that joy would come in the morning? The reason why I know it would come in the morning, I tried it
for myself. So I'm saying to this family this afternoon, just trust in the Lord, and everything will be all right. As I'm reminded of a story I heard not too long ago, Enoch walked with God, just like Demetrius walked with Jesus. But there's anybody here walking with Jesus. That's why he said, Lord, I'm with you. Always, even until the end of the world. And it said that Enoch walked with God. And Enoch got to walking and talking with God. He kept on walking and talking with God. He just kept on walking and talking with God. Until they got so far, God said to Enoch, my house is right here. Come on, go home with me. Can't you see him trusting in the Lord? Can't you see him what weeping may endure for a night? But joy comes in the morning. God bless you, family. And walk with Jesus. Trust in the Lord to us. And he'll make everything all right. Trust in the Lord, then. Trust in the Lord. And he will make everything all right. What we don't understand right now, we'll understand it better by and by. Much as we are.
Amen.
To know that
God is keeping me.
Hey. no matter what you're going through, I know that you can stand. For your life is in His hands. Listen.